I think the very valuable part of the Invasive Mussel Collaborative is it brings a lot of very good minds together. It brings engaged experts in the field together, and when we get together in a room, we talk about it, we get excited about what's on the edge of research, what do we need to do next, what can we stretch to try to figure out of what we don't know about mussels. And you know, being out what we saw in the field today, they carpet the bottom of the lake, and to some degree you're going to be finding them across the lake here to Milwaukee throughout many of the lower Great Lakes. So the cumulative impact of them, so each of these small mussels, the cumulative impact is phenomenal. So even though the general public doesn't get to touch mussels, I think mussels touch their lives in a way of affecting their recreation and just changing the character of our Great Lakes.
Yeah, I think as a basic researcher working on Dreissena issues, it's really nice to be in the room when people are talking about the ecosystem impacts of what Dreissena do. You know, understanding that the research that you've done and that I know, you know, other colleagues have done gets interpreted and gets brought into that process.
You know, we have to continue to look at alternatives and try and find solutions either that are out there now that we're just not aware of, or to continue to push research to find you know, something new that doesn't exist right now. And that's the power of the collaborative. I think you get researchers and resource managers and people with an economic interest in this. You get them all together, then you're going to have much better chance of having a funding solution earlier than if people are working on it individually.
We're looking at other new tools, chemical tools such as carbon dioxide is one thing that's being researched by USGS and others, particularly in the western United States. Then there's also some new exciting tools, more of a biotech approach. So you're looking at interference RNA. That type of technology is being looked at for medical use, for agriculture use, and also now for invasive species use.
Our involvement with the collaborative has been really helpful in terms of sharing resources, sharing information, but also just being a platform to discuss novel management strategies where there aren't any. And so the strategies that we're trying in Minnesota that are being tried in other states are new, and how we communicate them to our partners, I think really is important, just in sharing information, but also figuring out what is working and what isn't working.
I think what the difference is for the collaborative is that it's trying to keep all parties involved the whole way through, so that we're trying to come up with that common solution, but really with direct representation, so we can take those solutions back and manage them jurisdictionally rather than relying on one group, the Great Lakes Commission or the Mussel Collaborative directly, to solve the problem on their own.
With the collaborative, we've all come together to agree on a strategy for management of control of mussels in the Great Lakes region. And ultimately what we want to do is drive ongoing investments in research and policy. We do have tools. We're still learning how to use them and what could be feasibly applied in our larger lake systems where there are significant infestations. But those infestations are continuing to have dramatic effects on our ecosystem, on our recreational uses, on drinking water. So it's important that we continue to work on this problem. In addition, there are water bodies still across the region that are uninfested, and they have assets and value and benefits that are worth protecting if we can prevent future infestations as well.